हम लोग प्रीचिंग करना होगा और काउंस ऑफ प्रैक्टिस मुख्यमंत्री महात्मा गांधी। तो महात्मा गांधी द सेंट्रल फिगर फॉर ही बिलीव इन गॉड ग्राम स्वराज। ग्राम स्वराज इज फॉर व्हाट? ग्राम स्वराज इज फॉर द वेलफेयर ऑफ పవర్టీ మస్ట్ బి రిడ్యూస్డ్ బై 50%. వాట్ వాజ్ ద బేస్? నాకు బేస్ ఉండాలి కదా. సో బేస్ ఇస్ 1993. వాట్ ఎవర్ పవర్టీ లెవెల్స్ ఆఫ్ దే మస్ట్ బి రిడ్యూస్డ్ బై 50% బై 2015. దట్ వాజ్ ద టార్గెట్ ఆఫ్ ఎండిజీస్. సో హౌ టు అచీవ్ దీస్ ఎండిజీస్ ఇస్ ద టాస్క్ బిఫోర్ ద గవర్నమెంట్. సో గవర్నమెంట్ హ్యావ్ సెవరల్ ప్రోగ్రామ్స్ టు అడ్రస్ దీస్. Many of these programs are rooted in the rural development department, because most of the poor are located where they are in the rural areas. Of course, urban poor are also there, but number of people, 80% of the rural poor are in the village rural areas. So what is the below poverty line? There is a line below which people are above poverty line, below and below poverty. How many people are there? So what is the percentage of BPL families? It's 30%. So trends, recent trends indicate that these poverty levels are getting reduced. They are getting reduced, but not at the rate at which we are expecting. But the rate of fall of poverty is not, rate of fall of poverty is not commensurate, is not adequate. So there is slow rate of fall of poverty. So as I have already told, 80% of the BPL families are residing in villages. But in the last 5 years, some significant change happened. What is it? Everywhere, in whichever village you go, and whomever you contact, earlier there was no money. Now there is plenty of money. Only 100 rupees note, 500 rupees note you find with them. What is the cause? Yeah, it is the Mahatma Gandhi NREGS program that brought good chunks of money into the hands of the rural poor. So that is a very good development. Very good development. And it has actually transformed the lifestyle of the people in the rural area to some extent. It made a very good beginning. Very good beginning. So which is the plan now? Which is the 5-year plan now for which is currently going? 12. So earlier 11th plan, actually this NREGS started in 11th plan. It injected a lot of money. Besides that, there was another program called Bharat Nirman. You know Bharat Nirman? So Bharat Nirman also, I will tell you what are the components of Bharat Nirman. So both these programs, NREGS and Bharat Nirman, together pumped in a lot of money into the rural areas so that people got benefited. Then if you take Rural Development Department in Australia, it has a vision. What is that vision and the mission? Vision and the mission of the department. What is this task? Task is to reduce poverty. Poverty in 13 sali. That is the rural development. అయితే ఎట్లా తగ్గించాలి అనే దానికి దేర్ ఆర్ రీజన్స్ ఎట్లా అనే దానికి ఒక స్ట్రాటజీ ఉంది. ఒకటేమంటే దెర్ ఆర్ త్రీ కాంపోనెంట్స్ ఆఫ్ రెడ్యూసింగ్ పవర్టీ వాట్ ద రూరల్ డెవలప్మెంట్ డిపార్ట్మెంట్స్ సే. వన్ ఈజ్ ఇంక్రీజింగ్ ద లైవ్లీహుడ్ ఆపర్చునిటీస్. వాట్ ఈస్ లైవ్లీహుడ్? జీవనోపాధి. సో వన్ ఈజ్ ఇంక్రీజింగ్ ద లైవ్లీహుడ్ ఆపర్చునిటీస్ ఇన్ వన్. Then providing social nets, social security nets, means against the risks. Only risks on the insurance, so people may suffer illness, people may die in accidents, people may die in harness, while working they may die. So there must be some social security nets. Particularly these are required to the poor people, because they depend mostly on their body. Their body is their asset. They have to take manual labor every day. So for doing manual labor, their body is their asset. So they have to keep their body healthy every day. So therefore, social security nets are very much required in the rural development, particularly to the rural poor. Then what else is required? Third point is infrastructure is required. A good amount of infrastructure is required. Connectivity by roads, connectivity by communication. So those infrastructure facilities also required for rural development. So three important issues are increasing the livelihood opportunities, second is the increasing the social nets, third is the increasing the infrastructure facilities in the rural areas. These are the three important issues in the rural development. So what will happen if these things are done? Say whatever, all the three steps are fulfilled, what will happen? Finally, it increases the quality of life of the rural people. So, what for the government is there? Government is there to provide some better facilities to the people so that they will have an improved quality of life. So, finally, everything is linked to the improved quality of life. That is more so in the rural areas. And who are the most benefited lot if these programs are implemented? Is it the rich or the poor? So poor and vulnerable sections, marginalized sections, particularly SC, ST, minority, backward, these people will be benefited much if these programs are implemented. So purpose of the government is to bring them up, to reduce the inequalities between rich and poor. So inequalities between rich and poor can be done only if you target the poor first. So those targeting poor first is the concept in rural development. So you have to target first. Target means not eating. Yes, hit their poverty so that they will come out of their poverty. That is the concept. So rural development, okay, what is development? Development at any? Development is something invention or in some invention or any innovation. చెప్పండి, కెన్ యూ సే డెవలప్మెంట్ ఈజ్ అన్ ఇన్నోవేషన్? యాజ్ ఎ ఇన్వెన్షన్, ఎ న్యూ ఇన్వెన్షన్. సో టేక్ ఎ కెమెరా. నౌ ఆఫ్ కోర్స్ నౌ డేస్ న్యూ కెమెరాస్ ఆర్ ఐ థింక్ దే ఆర్ డిజిటైజ్డ్ అండ్ వెల్ సోఫిస్టికేటెడ్. బట్ ఓల్డ్ అండ్ డేస్ కెమెరా వాజ్ టేకెన్ టు ఎ ఫిల్మ్. వాట్ వాజ్ ద ఫిల్మ్? ఫిల్మ్ వాజ్ బ్లాక్ ఇన్ కలర్. So if you take photograph and you store that photograph in a negative, so that negative can be seen as a photograph only when you develop it. That is called development. So what are you developing? There is something already available. There is something already available in the negative that you are developing through some improved chemical, by using some chemical. So here also rural development is nothing but there is something already on the ground in the rural areas. What you are doing is you are only developing it. You are not innovating, inventing anything new. That is the concept of development. Okay, we don't go too much details into that. Then rural development has some 5-6 major programs. What are those 5-6 major programs? As you already aware, it is MG, NR, E, G, A. MGA based scheme or program. Second one, you have NRLM. What is this NRLM? National Rural Livelihoods Mission. What is mission? This is livelihoods mission. What is mission? Mission is a machine like this thing. What is mission? So dictionary meaning of mission is a committed work to do something. It's a committed work to do something. Yeah? So then third, they call it IAY. You know IAY? Indira Awas Yojana, relating to Hoshi. Four, PM GSY. Pradhan Mantri, Grameen, Sadak Yojana. This is Sadak. Sadak means road. Sadak is road. This is Prime Minister Grameen Sadak Yojana. Rural roads connected program. Indira Awas. Awas means house. Awas means house. Then fifth point is NSAP. What is NSAP? National Social Assistance Program. Social Assistance. I was referring to social nets, social network in the government, social net, social security net. Social Security Assistance. National Social Assistance Program. It is called mostly National Social Assistance Program. Social assistance. Then sixth is IWMP, Integrated Watershed Management Program. IWMP, Watershed Management. You know watershed? Watershed is a geohydrological area, having a common drain. Ekkada water nilu vanna kuda anta kuda common drain vastundi. That is called the watershed. Atlanti integrated watershed management program. So these are the major 6 programs of rural development. If you take up these programs in a systematic manner, the quality of life in the rural areas and poverty in the rural areas will be reduced. That is the objective of this program. So if you go into details, then there is another concept called inclusive growth. What is inclusive growth? Today I will take up this one, and then this one. Three. Other three, I think, may not find time to deal with some other day. So NREGS, so I was already referring to you about the lot of money pumped into the system through MGNREGS, and there was another program where waiver of debts was taken by the government. Thousands of crores of debt was waived. Waiving of debt and agriculture. Appulnu maafi cheyadu. Runalanu maafi cheyadu. Aa program kuda pedda ethana jarigindi. So dani valla kuda prajala daggara dabbulu baaga undi. Deeni valla last 7 years lo there was lot of inclusive growth pradhananga NDRRAS plus debt waiver. ఈ రెండు బాగా పనిచేశాయి. దీనివల్ల ఏమైతుంది? when lot of money is available to the people, it enhances their what? It enhances their purchasing power. It increases your purchasing power. Yes, you can purchase a car immediately. Even as now nowadays NREGS employee employment beneficiaries, they are purchasing motorcycles. Even though they do manual and they have thousands of rupees, they are purchasing motorcycles. It is a dream for them. Earlier, they don't even have a bicycle. Because the purchasing power has increased with a lot of money pumping into the system through these people. And who are the most benefited? Is the old people or the young people? So these people. Huh? I think youth. Youth are now going to NREGS work. Any of you have gone? I think there are some students, degree college, PG students, who are going to NREGS manual work during the summer vacation. And they have decent money of 5-6,000 rupees per month. So that money they use for this studies purpose. I think you may not have that opportunity because you may be coming from so downgraded family, so much downgraded. But there are good number of college students, PG students, university students who are taking up NREGS work. They have good number of success stories also. So they use the proceedings with money to prosecute, to execute their studies, yes, studies. So, the Acharan is the student to degree in history. So, don't you find any? Okay. So, impact is impact of NREGS, impact studies for men, and those details will come. Now, the task before the department is how to sustain this momentum? Now money is with people, purchasing power has increased because of these things. And how to sustain that momentum? Means how to continue that. So suddenly if you withdraw this thing, suddenly if you withdraw this facility to get daily incomes, so whatever progress you have made will be nullified. So therefore, there must be a continue, which is sustain this NREGS program further. So for that, NREGS must be implemented in a systematic way for years together so that the aspirations of the rural people can be met. And so what are total, how taken the rural development department, RD department, it has a total budget allocation of how much? Around 73,175 crores is the budget of the department. It's a very big money spending department. They are not earning anything. This department is the most money spending department. Around 73,000 crores of rupees every year is pumped into the system. Then rural development has, of course, six programs I have already told you. This rural development department has, besides rural development program, there is another land resources unit. Land watersheds they want to take up. And another is the drinking water and sanitation. So three components of rural department were there earlier. Now this drinking water sanitation became a separate ministry. Only two are the local and the land resources departments are with the panchayat raj ministry. Now there are three autonomous institutions of rural development. One is NIRD. What is NIRD? National Institute of Rural Development. Where is it? Rajendra Nagar, Hyderabad. There are several Rajendra Nagars. Delhi law is Rajendra Nagar, Bihar law is Rajendra Nagar, Hyderabad, Nayar. It is under RD. Then another is Kapat. What is Kapat? What is the Kapat? Council for Advancement of People's Action and Rural Technology. Council for Advancement of People's Action and Rural Technology. ఇది ఢిల్లీలో. దెన్ థర్డ్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్ ఈస్ డిజాస్టర్ ఆటోనమస్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఫర్ రూరల్ ఎన్ఆర్ఆర్డిఏ. వాట్ ఈస్ ఎన్ఆర్ఆర్డిఏ? నేషనల్ రూరల్ రోడ్స్ డెవలప్మెంట్ ఏజెన్సీ. నేషనల్ రూరల్ రోడ్స్ డెవలప్మెంట్ ఏజెన్సీ ఎన్ఆర్ఆర్డిఏ. So these institutions are helping the rural development department in their Kapat people. What do they do? There is a rural technology in which agriculture can be improved, in which even ploughing activity can be improved, transportation in rural villages can be improved, drudgery on the animals can be reduced. So if you allow the animals to carry tons of goods, animals will suffer. So therefore, technology, with the intervention of technology, they want to bring freely mobile vehicles, mobile rural transport systems. As a bullock cart, a well-made bullock cart will reduce the burden and drudgery on the part of the animal. So that kind of rural technology they involve and they help in the rural development. So these are the three. So if and then the kind of questions people will ask in the examination, you don't know. Simply Kapat means ABCD. So whatever you have written may be the correct answer, but they may simply twist some other and give you. You have to identify. So the kind of questions people may ask, you don't know, but you must be prepared for everything and anything. And one important, the civil service says, but in the group one also, the concept is you must know everything. Means you must, there must have no doubt in your sense. So there must be no scope for any doubt. So therefore, some questions will be twisted to test your thorough knowledge. Whether you have only simple bookish knowledge or simple memorizing knowledge, or you have a thorough knowledge. So to test your thorough knowledge, a good number of questions that I will tell you in the process. What kind of questions people will ask? Then come to the NREGA. When was it started? 2005. So 2005. But in the first batch of 200 districts started in 2005-6. So which is the in the world, which is the biggest state-sponsored employment program in the country, not in the country, in the world. In the whole world, there is one employment program which is sponsored by the government, which has a very massive scale covering crores of people. Which is that program? NREGA only. This has that kind of a distinction. In the world, this is the biggest employment generation program. And how can you say that? There must be some proof. The proof is that you can call the outcomes of NREGAs, how big it is. One is the employment generated is how much? 1348 crores per Sunday అంటే మ్యాన్ డేస్. మ్యాన్ అని ఎందుకు కనెక్ట్ చేయాలంటే ఉమెన్ కూడా ఉంది. మ్యాన్ డే అంటే వన్ డే ఈజ్ ఎ మ్యాన్ డే. ఇఫ్ ఐ వర్క్ ఫర్ వన్ డే ఈజ్ ఎ మ్యాన్ డే. ఇఫ్ 10 పీపుల్ వర్క్ అండ్ సింగిల్ డే హౌ మెనీ మ్యాన్ డేస్ అని చెప్పి 10 మ్యాన్ డేస్ అని చెప్పారు. లైక్ వైజ్ 1348 crores ఆఫ్ మ్యాన్ డేస్ పీపుల్స్ పర్సన్స్ డేస్ సో ఫార్. ఇమాజిన్ హౌ బిగ్ మ్యాన్ డేస్ హౌ మెనీ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ మ్యాన్ డేస్ వర్క్. దెన్ వాట్ వాస్ ద మనీ పంపుడ్ త్రూ ఎన్ఆర్ఈజీఎస్ ఫ్రమ్ ద బిగినింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ 2005? హౌ మచ్? ఇమాజిన్ హౌ మచ్ చెప్తారు ఎవరన్నా? 1,29,000 crores సో ఫార్ ఫ్రమ్ 2006 ఆన్వర్డ్స్ ఇన్ ది లాస్ట్ 7 ఇయర్స్ 1,29,000 crores of NREGS money went into the hands of the wage earners. Went into the hands of the wage earners so far. Then how many people got benefited? There are 5 crore rural households got benefited. Households, 5 crore rural households got benefited so far. In the last 7 years. These are the latest figures quoted by the government. And this is one dimension of employment generation. Second important issue in the outcomes is the reach. Reach means to whom this program is reaching. It is reaching the most vulnerable, most deprived people in the society. Who are there? SC, ST people and even disabled. Disabled can also go and work in the NREGS. So the reach is very big. And now SC, ST is 51 total, out of the total benefited, 51% are from SC, ST. And 47% are women. Of course, women come from SCST also. This 47 inclusive of SCST. SCST women kuda dindulo kalisi are 47. So, NREGS Act say, what is the reservation for women? A minimum of this much coverage should be there in NREGS. What is this minimum? 1/3. మినిమం ఆఫ్ 1/3 ఆఫ్ ద బెనిఫిషరీస్ మస్ట్ బి ఉమెన్ అనేది రూల్. బట్ వీ హావ్ ఎక్సీడెడ్ 1/3 మీన్స్ 33 1/3 దెన్ ద రూల్స్ ఏ 33 1/3 యూ హావ్ ఎక్సీడెడ్ 47% బికాస్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఇంప్లిమెంటెడ్ ఇన్ ఫేవర్ ఆఫ్ ఉమెన్. నథింగ్ రాంగ్ ఇన్ ద మినిమం ఆఫ్ 1/3 మస్ట్ బి దేర్ బికాస్ బట్ యూ హావ్ కమ్ టు 1/2. దట్ ఈస్ ఎ సిగ్నిఫికెంట్ అచీవ్మెంట్. Then what kind of works were taken up? Then strengthening, third one is the third outcome. We are telling, we are discussing about the outcomes of this NREGS program. One is employment generated, second is the reach is went to the people. Third one is the natural resources were improved. What kind of natural resources were improved? Those details are included. Natural resources were improved by taking up 146 lakh works. Number of works taken up so far under NREGS was 146 lakhs. So it improved natural resources in the local environment, local irrigation systems, local village level environment improved. Then what about the wages? Wage structure. Earlier, before this program, how much wage was given to a laborer in a village? it was hardly 30 rupees. In some villages only 20 rupees. Now, with the simple introduction of this program, the wage rate increased to 70 rupees, to 100 rupees, 5 years back. Now the average wage rate is 115 rupees. Average wage rate in the country is 115 rupees. And highest rate is given where? In Haryana now. In Haryana, 191 rupees is the average rate per day. Whereas low is 122 rupees in Bihar. That is the rate given per day. And the state government will announce this rate per day. And depending on the work turnout, they will give the wages. And in 2005, it was only 60-70 rupees. Now it is 115 rupees. So what is the increment in last 5-6 years? Around 81% increment in the wage rate increase. In the last 5 years, I think even a government employee did get 81% increase in his salary. So a person getting 10,000 rupees must be getting 18,000 rupees by now. But it's not the case in the other sector. But in NRECS, you find 81% increase in the last 5-6 years in the wage rate, in the rate of wage. And then fifth outcome is the financial inclusion. What is financial inclusion? Financial inclusion. These are the words used in several contemporary issues in the government. Financial inclusion and debt. How you are connected to the finance system? You are connected to the finance system through what? By opening a bank account. So opening bank accounts is financial inclusion in the beginning stage, in the first stage. Then accessing loan, taking loan from the bank in the next stage. So opening up accounts in the formal financial institutions like banks, post offices. Post office will also give you a bank account, one savings account. So, because of NRECS, around 8.4 crores of accounts, 8.4 crores of accounts are opened. Who opened these accounts? These wage laborers. So earlier these people don't have any accounts. Now with NRECS, they got opened this 8.4 crores of accounts. So these are the significant achievements. Significant achievements, these are the outcomes. Then there is effective E means electronic. FMS means finance management system. So electronic finance management system has come in. So all the accounts are transparent now. You can view and see any accounts of the NRECS workers. How much money is deposited into their account. So there is a centralized EFMS system at the national level and state level also. And there is EMMS system. What is EMMS system? EFMS means financial management system. MMS means, what is this MMS? Anybody? NRECS, there is one register called muster register. What is that muster register? So muster register, in the muster register, people record how many days this particular person has worked. So that is called muster. Muster rolls record. So muster management system. This is also through cell phones. Now masters are maintained through cell phones. So there will be one leader who records in his cell phone that so and so has attended today for NREGSOI. And he will send that information through the web. And in the web it is recorded. So and so today attended, that is called e-muster. And based on that, payments are made. So based on that attendance, payments are made. So EMMS, EFMS are the two important components in the NREGSOI. Now it is also being linked to Aadhaar. Aadhaar even. Aadhaar is given by whom? Which is the central agency which is giving Aadhaar? UAID. Aadhaar is also now, they are planning to link. In 51 districts it is going in a pilot. I think it will be increasing year by year. So these are the outcomes of NREGS. And now you appreciate the significant impact that NREGS has made in the last 6-7 years in rural areas. Now with this appreciation, you can now look backward. What were the employment generation schemes that existed before NREGS? Actually, some people, they go into the history of wage employment. And NREGS people may be knowing now, but what prompted people to move from the earlier system to the present NREGS system must be known. I think big number of bits may also come. How these NREGS programs have evolved over a period of time. So it all started in 1960 in independent India. In 1960-61, there was a program called RMP. What is RMP? Registered Medical Practitioner. RMP is Registered Medical Practitioner, but this RMP is different. Rural Manpower Program. Rural Manpower Program. People like me, given an opportunity to set question paper, I may ask, which is the first and foremost wage employment program in the independent India? This is the Rural Manpower Program in 1960-61. The first wage employment program. Followed by CRSE. What is CRSE? In 71-72. This is CRAS scheme. CRAS means immediate CRAS scheme for rural employment. For rural employment, RE. Rural employment. Then RWP in 72. Rural Works Program. This is Rural Works Program. Again, it was converted into DPAP. What is DPAP? Drought Prone Areas Program. It was transformed, Rural Works Program was transformed to DPAP subsequently. Then in 1977, there was FWP. What is FWP? Food for Work Program. Food for Work Program. Parijesi Aharam Sambhalisthu. Parijesi Aharam Sambhalisthu. Food for Work Program. Then in 1980, there was NREP. National Rural Employment Program. National Rural Employment Program. Then in RLEGP. Rural Landless Employment guarantee. Employment guarantee program. This is the first time in the history you are looking at guarantee. That too for rural landless people. This was in, of course, in the 80s only. It is also in the 80s. Then, these are the old schemes. After 80s, there was one JRY. This was famous, popular, because it was implemented everywhere, in all villages. JRY, Jawahar Rozgar Yojana. JRY, Jawahar Rozgar Yojana. In 93-94. Then, JRY Tarvata program in the EAS. Employment Assurance Scheme. Employment Assurance Scheme. Actually, who started this program? Who named this program? EAS? Is correct, but there was an officer whose surname was also ES. He resides in Vizag. He was a secretary in the government of India at that time. He was EAS Sharma. EAS Sharma, he actually named that program at that time. He actually formulated that program. And he named it as EAS program, Employment Assurance Program, which goes by his surname, EAS Sharma. And it's very EAS Sharma. Then there was, after JRY EAS, which was the other, next, JGSY. JGSY, in 1999-2000. Of course, years are not important, but this order is important. You may not be expected to remember all the years, but order is important. So JGSY means Jawahar Gram Samruddhi Yojana. Jawahar Gram Samruddhi. Samruddhi means richness. Jawahar Gram Samruddhi Yojana. Jawahar Gram Samruddhi Yojana. Then in JGSY, JRY was merged actually. This JRY got merged into JGSY. Then HGRY. HGRY was Sampurna Gramin Rozgar Yojana. HGRY, Sampurna Gramin Rozgar Yojana. And finally, before NREGS, there was a program called, before NREGS and HGRY, in between there is one program called NFFWP, National Food for Work Program. Earlier it was only Food for Work Program. This was National Food for Work Program in 2005. So, National Food for Work program was there, and all these programs finally merged into final NREGS. So this is the evolution history of wage employment program in independent India in the last 50-60 years. Okay, what is important for examination point of view? People may ask you, so which of these sequences are correct? Question is, which of these sequences are correct? One, FWP, JRY, HGRY, so combination, sir. A combination. B combination. JRY, FWP, HGRY. C combination. HGRY. So this kind of questioning there is fine. ఇందులో అంతకంటే ఎక్కువ ఏమన్నా అండ్ అబ్రివేషన్ FWP స్టాండ్స్ ఫర్ అంతకంటే దీంట్లో గుర్తు పెట్టుకొని దాని డీటెయిల్స్ చేయాల్సిన అవసరం లేదు. వాట్ ఈస్ అబ్రివేషన్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ అండ్ విచ్ కమ్స్ వెల్ విచ్ ఈస్ ఫస్ట్ విచ్ ఈస్ సెకండ్ దట్ ఈస్ ఎఫ్ సి. ఓకే క్లియర్? I think now you can set a question paper based on this. Using all these things, you can set your own question paper. That will fetch you. Or a team of two or three can sit and prepare a question paper on one chapter and even distribute to your friends to write that. And another team can prepare a question paper on some other topic and it can be exchanged over others. So this kind of a mutual exchange of question papers, setting up and exchanging question papers will be useful, particularly for this kind of examination. Then, okay, what is important in analysis compared to others, compared to previous program? What is the significant change that was brought in the analysis program? Can anybody name? Several programs we have seen, around 15 programs we have seen. But how NREGS is different from the earlier programs? They are different in only one approach. The fundamental difference is, it is a rights-based approach. Right, R-I-G-H-T. Rights-based approach. Rights to whom? Rights to the wage seeker. Rights-based approach. Rights to the wage seeker. Yes, I am a manual wage seeker. I have right now. I have right to what? To demand for work. So that kind of a demand for work has come to a right in the NREGS. That kind of a demand and right was not there earlier. So this is the first program which gave rights to the people, rights to the people to access work and to get benefit. And one important bit is, before NREGS was started in 2005, a similar program existed in one of the states. Which was that state? A similar program existed in one of the states which they implemented for last 7-8 years, and unsuccessful implementation of that scheme in that particular state, people from other parts of the country studied it and have taken those rights approach into this program. Which was that state? This is a very important bit. So the entire NREGS has a bearing on that. The background of NREGS was drawn from that particular scheme. That was, okay, 1,000 rupees per second. Orissa. It is Maharashtra. Maharashtra Employment Guarantee Act. Maharashtra Employment Guarantee Act 1997. They have an act right from 1997. They implemented it over a period of time. And the learnings and success stories from this Maharashtra Employment Guarantee Act was taken into the analysis. Okay. So the act came in, or NREGS came in 2005, date 5-9-2005, if you have a name, fascination to dates, you can also have this. And actually it started on 2-2-2006 in how many districts? Around 200 districts in the country. It started in 2006 in 200 districts. Then come to the, what is the aim of this NREGS? Somebody may ask me. Yes, the aim, it has a very specific aim. Specific aim and a bit can also come to the slave. It aims at providing gas days of guaranteed employment in a financial year, in a financial year to every rural household adult member who volunteered to do gas work. ఏంటి ఉంటుంది డాష్ ఏంటి ఇయర్ 100 డేస్ దిస్ వన్ అన్స్కిల్డ్ మాన్యువల్ వర్క్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీ రూరల్ హౌస్ హోల్డ్ ఇస్ ఆల్సో ఇంపార్టెంట్ అండ్ అడల్ట్ ఇస్ ఆల్సో ఇంపార్టెంట్ 17-year-old కాంట్ గో అండ్ క్లెయిమ్ ఎనాలిసిస్ because he is not adult. So to demand for work, one must attain an age of how much? 18 years. So now any kind of questions people can ask you in a bit form, I can tell you good number of questions. Okay, under NREGS, which of the following is not correct? People can ask for a minimum of rural households can ask for a minimum of 100 days of work. True or false?
True.
Urban households can also ask for NREGS work.
False.
Also true, I am true or true. Urban households can also ask for NREGS work. No. False. So college students, PC students can also aspire for NREGS work. PC students can also aspire for NREGS work. True. Because PC students will have always taken more than 18 years. Any kind of, because this is the basic frame aim, this is the basic statement. So you must have this kind of a basic statement in your mind, and you must be conscious of every word. Even a small word can also utter you. Then what are the unique features of NREGS? The why these details I am telling you, the kind of questions, particularly the objective type questions people ask, you can't predict. If he is well versed with the subject, he can give very fantastic questions going into the core of the philosophy. So core philosophy, if you know, and you have to apply that core philosophy to the context. So knowing the facts and application of the fact to the contemporary world is also important. So I will read out, I think I can't write so many numbers because a lot of chemistry is there. NREGS is the first ever law internationally that guarantees wage employment in a very massive scale. It is the first ever international law. First ever law, international law, first ever Indian law, which has massive scale internationally. And no other country has this much of, no other country has this much of large employment, wage employment program. Then what kind of works are permitted? Here, in that one, I'm just going to know. How many works were permitted? 146 lakhs of works were permitted. Works were done. So what kind of works now? So those works were intended to reduce poverty, chronic poverty, poverty for last 50 years. That poverty can be removed if these works are implemented. So what kind of those works? The list I will give you. They are mostly drought proof, drought proof. Okay? Karuvunu nivarinche. And deforestation control. Deforestation adol and soil erosion control. Soil pokunda. Ilanti works ekkuva teesukunnaru sandarbhalu unnai. Ivanni kuda they are directly related to our control. Tarvata another important question is there is a significant role given to Panchayat Raj institutions for planning, implementation and auditing and evaluation also. So Panchayat Raj institutions, Gram Panchayats, Block Panchayats and District Panchayats are given a role in implementing NREGs. These are the important features of NREGs. Then another features also I will read out. So rights, we have already discussed that this is the rights based program. The rights based framework for all adult members of a rural household willing to work unskilled manual work can be covered in this. There is a time bound guarantee. What is this time bound guarantee? How many days is the time bound? 100 days. 100 days for the total employment. But if I want to go for a work, I want to do some work, I will go and approach a Gram Panchayat and ask for a work. If I ask that, Panchayat has to provide me the work. Panchayat has to give me the work within how many days?
15 days.
In 15 days they have to give. So what happens if people don't give? If Panchayat don't give, what will happen? They are eligible for unemployment allowance. They are eligible for unemployment allowance. Yes, you give me work or unemployment allowance. Either of the two. So that is the time bound guarantee of 15 days for provision of employment. Otherwise, unemployment allowance needs to be paid. So up to 100 days. This 100 days norm is for an individual or for what? That's why whatever you have written is important. Read that and tell me. This 100 days is for an individual or to a family? Student, Malavsa student. 100 days and an individual ka or family ka? Rural household. Household means a family. So in Hyderabad city, there are 35,000 households, for example. So population is more than 35,000. So this entitlement of 100 days is for a rural household, not to a person. So if three persons in a family, they want to do work, all three can contribute to 100. ముగ్గురికి కలిపి కూడా 100 లోపలే రావాలి 100 దాటేదానికి లేదు బట్ ఇన్ సమ్ స్టేట్స్ దే హ్యావ్ పర్మిటెడ్ మోర్ దాన్ 100 ఇన్ ఎస్సీ ఎస్టీ ఫ్యామిలీస్ పర్టికులర్ ఇన్ ఆంధ్రప్రదేశ్ ఆల్సో దే హ్యావ్ గాన్ అప్ టు 150 డేస్ ఫర్ ఎస్సీ ఎస్టీ ఫ్యామిలీస్ ఇన్ సమ్ స్టేట్స్ హ్యావ్ ఆల్సో గివెన్ 200 డేస్ బట్ యాక్ట్ సే యూనిట్ ఈస్ రూరల్ హౌస్ హోల్డ్ నాట్ ద ఇండివిజువల్ అందుకనే బాగా క్లియర్గా తెలుసుకోవాల్సిన విషయాలు ఇట్లాంటి మైండ్ అది మిగతా వాళ్ళకు ఈ సివిల్ సర్వీస్ గ్రూప్ వన్ ఆస్పిరెంట్స్కి ఏంటంటే హౌ పర్ఫెక్ట్లీ యు ఆర్ లెర్నింగ్ ఇంటు అండ్ హౌ యాక్యురేట్లీ యు ఆర్ లెర్నింగ్ ఇంటు సో యాక్యురసీ ఆఫ్ లెర్నింగ్ ఓన్లీ మియర్ సింపుల్ నోయింగ్ ద ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ నాకు బట్ యు హావ్ క్రిటికల్ ఎనలైజ్ సో ఒక విషయం వచ్చినప్పుడు దానికి అన్ని యాంగిల్స్లో అన్ని కోణాలు తీసుకొని యూ హ్యావ్ టు గెట్ ఓన్లీ దట్ ఎస్సెన్స్ దట్ కరెక్ట్ ఎస్సెన్స్ తర్వాత is the ratio of 60-40 in NR is? 60 is?
Central.
That is 75-25. 60 is waste and material. So 60% of the money can go towards the wages. If you want to do some work, some material is also required. Sometimes some brick is required, some cement is required, some concrete is required. For that, material component is 40%. 60-40 is that. And unit for recording, unit for deciding is gram panchayat. 60-40 and a panchayat ka panchayat. The panchayat lo 10 lakhs work chestunte 6 lakhs wage pay cheyali minimum. 40% 4 lakhs rupayalu material quality. So unit is gram panchayat. So NREGS lo are there any contractors? Contractors can be given these works, yes or no? No, no contractor can be given. If contractors wish to MI, then they will put machines. So they have to do work, some earth work, ground work. Instead of engaging labor, they bring a proclaim and do the same work and get the work with 20% rate and take 80% with each market. That is not the purpose of NREGS. The purpose of NREGS is labor intensive, labor oriented. Therefore, no contractor and no machinery. Machines cannot be used. Even if the biggest machine they can use is only, yes, Gattapara, Proba, Adi, Para, Paral Gappa, no other instrument they can use. So, no machinery, no contractor. So big maker, yes, contractors are prohibited in NREGS, correct? No machinery can be used, correct? So you have to learn now, you know, for all of them. So 75-25, that is for central state. Then what is Gram Sabha? Earlier you have seen Gram Sabha. Gram Sabha can take registered voters of that particular panchayat. All registered voters of the panchayat are called Gram Sabha. So they attend, they meet at one place and they decide on some important issues. So Gram Sabha has given the power to recommend works. Gram Sabha can recommend the works. So whatever works were recommended by Gram Sabha, the Gram Panchayat will take and include in the action plan. So Gram Panchayat will prepare action plan based on the recommendations of Gram Sabha. Gram Sabha is, Gram Panchayat is different. Gram Panchayat is elected 10-15 people members along with Sarpanch. So they will prepare action plan based on the recommendations of Gram Sabha and they send that action plan to where? To the block. Block means here mandal. So there in the block we have a program officer for NREGS. There is a PO, program officer for NREGS. He will keep these works as in the shelf. They are called a shelf of works. Don't get confused. Shelf of work is nothing but the action plan that the Gram Panchayat want to take up in the next 1 year. In the next 1 year, we want to take up this 10.